We have a News 4 story that helps a girls' softball team head to Georgia for the big championship. We'll be right back.
Save money on gasoline? You don't have to give up.
Last night, Dave Gilbert told us about a girls' softball team on Long Island that's talented enough to be champs, but simply didn't have the money to travel to the championship game. Well, tonight, Dave reports, because of our story, a lot has changed since then.
These girls have Georgia on their mind because that's where the National Softball Championship will take place next month. This is the best girls softball team on the entire East Coast, the Belmore Merrick Long Island Braves, recent winners of the Amateur Softball Regional Conference. They're supposed to go to Tifton, Georgia and play for the national championship. But even though they're regional winners and deserve to go, up until tonight, it looked like Georgia was an impossible dream. You see, the team's broke, doesn't have the $8,000 needed for the trip south. Right after our story last night, we received many calls from viewers who wanted to contribute to the team. The Avon Corporation here in New York offered $4,000, half what's needed. And here on Broadway, star of the play, Agnes of God, Elizabeth Ashley, also called us to offer a donation.
I owe a friend of mine $2,500 that I've finally gotten together to pay him, and I just know that he'll understand, and I'll pay him 3 months from now, and I'll give that money to the girls' softball team to go to Georgia. I mean, it was just impulse. I picked up the telephone because, I mean, if I'm going to give money to any, I don't give much money away because I don't have much money. But I can't think of a better thing to do it, and they need it. They need it now.
And the people in New York are so nice for what they've done for us. I mean, you can't expect everybody to do this. Everybody just turns around, and they've really given us their love and everything, and I just appreciate it so much. We all do. I know it.
Not too excited, are they? Well, every New Yorker should be proud tonight. The Braves saying some think of New York as a cold, heartless city. But the many people pitching in to help the team shows the country New York is a city with a very big heart. Chuck?
Who was the little guy up front? Cheerleader there? Last night on News 4 New York at 11, Dave Gilbert told us about a baseball team in trouble. Well, now he has a follow-up report.
These girls are not just out for a little sun and exercise on the baseball diamond. They're serious softball players. In fact, this is the best girls softball team on the East Coast, the Belmore Merrick Long Island Braves. They recently won the Amateur Softball Association Mid-Atlantic Regional Conference. The Braves are now supposed to play for the national championship in Tifton, Georgia next month. But right now, it looks like these girls won't get a chance to go down to Georgia and compete for that title.
We just don't have the money. We need about $8,000 to get these girls down there, and trying our best to raise the funds, and with the economic conditions the way they are, we're just having a lot of difficulty.
As you can see, playing for the championship in Georgia is very important to the Braves.
I'm pretty disappointed because we went that far. Now, when we heard the margin of money that we needed, we all got a little bit disappointed, but we're going to do it.
Well, it looks like the story may have a happy ending. After seeing our newscast last night, Robert McMillan of the Avon Company offered a $4,000 donation, half the money needed.
I think the frustration that would exist if they didn't have this opportunity after winning the regional title would just be unfair, and we wanted to try to help out wherever we can.
Why did you want to help out as a company?
Well, again, I think the opportunity for these young people to get the opportunity to travel, to be able to see another part of the world, and I think probably if we took a poll, many of their mothers, maybe at one time or another, have been Avon representatives, and that's important to us, too.
Well, the Avon people are not the only News 4 viewers offering to help the Braves compete for the national title down there in Georgia. Since our story ran last night, we've received many calls from New Yorkers who want to contribute. So it looks like the Belmore Merrick Braves will be whistling Dixie next month. Gentlemen?
Thank you, Dave. Frank Fields along next.
In there. story. This girls' softball team is on its way to the championship.
Big championship. We'll be right back. Gilbert told us about a girls' softball team on Long Island that's talented enough to be champs, but simply didn't have the money to travel to the championship game. Well, tonight Dave reports, because of our story, a lot has changed since then.
Georgia! 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 Georgia!
These girls have Georgia on their mind because that's where the national softball championship will take place next month. This is the best girls softball team on the entire East Coast, the Belmore Merrick Long Island Braves, recent winners of the Amateur Softball Regional Conference. They're supposed to go to Tifton, Georgia, and play for the national championship. But even though they're regional winners and deserve to go, up until tonight, it looked like Georgia was an impossible dream. You see, the team's broke, doesn't have the $8,000 needed for the trip south. Right after our story last night, we received many calls from viewers who wanted to contribute to the team. The Avon Corporation here in New York offered $4,000, half what's needed. And here on Broadway, star of the play Agnes of God, Elizabeth Ashley, also called us to offer a donation.
I owe a friend of mine $2,500 that I've finally gotten together to pay him, and I just know that he'll understand, and I'll pay him 3 months from now, and I'll give that money to the girls' softball team to go to Georgia. I mean, it was just impulse. I picked up the telephone because, I mean, if I'm going to give money to any, I don't give much money away because I don't have much money. But I can't think of a better thing to do it, and they need it. They need it now.
And the people in New York are so nice for what they've done for us. I mean, you can't expect everybody to do this. Everybody just turns around, and they've really given us their love and everything, and I just appreciate it so much. We all do. I know it.
Not too excited, are they? Well, every New Yorker should be proud tonight. The Braves saying some think of New York as a cold, heartless city. But the many people pitching in to help the team shows the country New York is a city with a very big heart. Chuck?
Sir. Who's the little guy up front? Cheerleader there?
Yeah, they have a lot of cheerleaders now.
Thank you.
Amateur softball. Problem was, the series started tomorrow, or starts tomorrow, in Tifton, Georgia. At that time, the Belmore Merrick Braves did not have the cash to go. Well, after Dave's report, actress Liz Ashley chipped in, as well as the Avon Company. And this afternoon, the team took off for Georgia on the as the best team on the East Coast, and they hope to say thanks by coming back national champs. Now, Dave Gilbert.
Four sent Dave Gilbert along as the team prepares for its first big game there.
This is Tifton, Georgia, population some 12,000. Compared to Plains, Georgia, this is like the big city. Compared to New York City, this is like another planet. But for a group of Long Island, New York girls, Tifton, Georgia is heaven, at least for this week.
I love it. It's really different from New York. And, you know, I think the people down here are really nice.
Kathy Ryan is one of 15 Long Island girls here in Tifton now. They're members of a team. Although it looks like it, they're not here for a swim meet. They play the amateur girls softball team on the East Coast, the Belmore Merrick Braves. Tifton's hosting the World Series of girls softball. The Braves won the right to go for the national title here after clinching the East Coast title. It's a beautiful day to soak up the southern rays. The Braves can relax and enjoy some southern hospitality since there's no game for them today. Getting here has been a dream for the Braves. Sometimes dreams are better than reality, but not for these girls. Their bubble hasn't burst.
A lot of people told us they really don't like New Yorkers, but they're nice. Everyone's friendly. We made friends from people from Minnesota already and that. It's been good.
What do you think of the South so far? Your first time here?
It's good, but nothing beats New York.
The Braves would be sitting at home, not by the pool right now, if it wasn't for generous New Yorkers pitching in with money, paying their expenses. The Braves still insist it was a good investment.
Precise. I'm going to win.
Well, the Braves didn't come here to play water football, so after the dip, it's time to hit the practice field. As you can tell, the most important thing in their lives right now is softball. And they want to get in as much practice as possible before tomorrow's big game. In Tifton, Georgia, I'm Dave Gilbert, News 4, New York.
Dave will stay with the team in Georgia as long as they stay in the competition.
Young and Braves team, the girls softball team from Belmore, they're champs on the island, and thanks to News 4 viewers, they've raised money for a trip to Georgia and the national playoff. For today, they played their first game down there, and Dave Gilbert has a report from Georgia.
Yeah, I mean, I'm scared a little bit, but not as much as before.
Leslie Kornblum has every right to be a little nervous right now. No one in New York ever expected her team, the Belmore Merrick Braves, to be here in Tifton, Georgia. The Braves getting ready to play their first game in the World Series of Amateur Girls Softball, the national finals. Their coach even looks at the Braves' chance to compete here as a real miracle. You see, this is the first year of the Braves' existence, so coming to the national finals is a miracle.
We went into the Long Island Ponytail League just for experiment, yeah, and everything just kept going. We just kept winning and winning.
It was just an experiment you never expected to be?
Never, never.
It doesn't look like the Braves will have an easy time here. Their first opponent, the Massillon, Ohio Tigers, a seasoned team, been to the finals last year. But the New York girls are still confident.
We're going to win. Everyone's so excited. Everyone's so psyched up. I think we're going to do it.
Well, the Braves have the enthusiasm to win, but not the pitching or hitting. They just couldn't catch the Tigers, Ohio winning 8-1.
The finals, the Massillon Stars had 8 runs, 13 hits, committed 1 error.
We are so mad right now. We are going to win. Yes. Yeah, we're going to feel, we feel confident now. It's just a little slow start, but we're going to pick it up right away.
The Braves may have lost the game, but they sure haven't lost their spirit. The girls are still considering themselves winners just by getting a chance to compete in the national finals. Not bad for a team's first year. In Tifton, Georgia, I'm Dave Gilbert, News 4, New York.
Well, we have some good news, though. The Braves won their second game late this afternoon and will continue their try for the championship over the weekend. Georgia, they lost their first game to the Massillon Tigers, but they won two more before losing their second game this evening, and those two defeats eliminate the Braves from the series. Afterward, the girls were disappointed, but the Braves still consider themselves winners, considering the fact that they made it all the way to the World Series of softball in their first year of existence. Not too bad.
It won the championship for this region, but did not have the money to travel to the national playoffs in Georgia. After News 4's Dave Gilbert told the girls' story, our viewers responded by donating the money that the team needed. And the Braves have been playing in Tifton, Georgia for the past couple of days. Well, we're sorry to tell you, the Braves lost their game last night and knocked them out of the playoffs, but they did win two of the contests in Tifton. They remain champs in the eyes of their fans on Long Island. And tonight at 11, Dave will talk to the football team from Long Island, and they are the champions for this region of the country. But a few weeks ago, it looked like they would not be able to attend the national playoffs in Georgia. They didn't have the money for the trip. News 4's Dave Gilbert told that story, and our viewers saw to it that the Braves' money problems were solved. Tonight, the girls are on their way home. No, they didn't win in Georgia, but as Dave reports, the Braves still feel like winners.
The Braves are celebrating, taking a late-night dip after the last game in the National Softball Finals. Looking at them, you'd think they're leaving Tifton, Georgia with the national trophy. Actually, they only won 2 out of 4 games, eliminated from the tournament after the last loss.
I would have thought you'd be really down tonight.
No, it's just an accomplishment that we got here. That's all we care about, is we got here, that's it.
Tifton, Georgia, for most of the girls on the Braves, is the farthest they've traveled outside of New York City in their lives. Although this small southern city is a far cry from the hustle of New York City, most of the girls will cherish their experience here for the rest of their lives. Georgia will always be on their minds.
Georgia, Georgia, the whole day through.
It's a lot better than everybody said. Everybody said, watch out, people down south don't like Northerners, but everybody's been really great to us. It's just like being back home.
Georgia. On my mind, Georgia.
They've been nice. I mean, it's just like everybody's one big family around here.
Georgia.
It's like a miracle. Dream come true. I can't believe we're here. Even though we didn't get to the top, we're still tops in our book.
People down here are nice, but there's still no place like New York.
It was just great. It was a great experience. Something I'll never forget.
Georgia. Georgia.
A quick personal note. After following the Braves' success story the past few weeks, all I can say is you won't find many other teams with as much enthusiasm and spirit. But you got to watch them around a pool.
Keep Georgia on my mind.
In my book, they're going back to New York winners. In Tifton, Georgia, I'm Dave Gilbert, News 4, New York.
That's our news for now. Good night.
Good night.